We haven't heard a lot of people say good things about Game of Thrones.
I haven't heard a single good thing.
I've heard a couple of people who said that they were happy with it and that they just think the people are being, you know, just want something to complain about.
But a lot
about.
Of people have been complaining.
There is one thing that almost everybody agrees on and that they liked about the finale, and that was the appearance of Robin Arryn, the character Robin Arryn, played by Lino Faccioli, because, how do I say this? He's basically viewed as sort of a Game of Thrones pinup now. And it was shocking to people because he started out as like just an annoying little rich kid.
Wait, was he like 8 years old when he started this?
I think it was something like that. He's 18 now, so that makes sense. So joining us right now, the surprise breakout star from the finale, Lino Faccioli. Lino, welcome to TMZ Live. How you doing?
I'm great. Thank you, guys.
Yeah, you should be great because everyone, you're the thing that people love about the finale. What was that like to wake up the next morning, the response that everyone had? And it was online. It was crazy.
It's insane. I still can't really get my head around what's happening. Yeah, it feels surreal, really.
I mean, so it's not like they hadn't seen you at all since the first season. You were on the show, but I guess they just didn't. I don't know. Did the producers sort of, how do I say this? Did they set you up for this in the finale that you were gonna? Did they do your hair differently for the big finale? Yeah. Why suddenly is everyone going, God, this guy's hot?
I don't know. I mean, it's still a mystery to me, really.
Well, I'm curious, Lena, what's it done? I mean, I would think, listen, it's the biggest show maybe in the history of television. You know, it, for what it is, in being on, you know, on HBO, and you know, I would think this opens a ton of doors, and you're the guy everybody liked when it all ended. So, are you getting offers? Is this, you know, suddenly leading man territory?
Yeah, it's you know, when people say it's like an overnight change, this really was an overnight change. It was like one day I went to bed. Just that weird kid, Game of Thrones, who no one really knew. I had like 5,000 followers or something. And in one night, I'd completely forgotten that the episode was going to air, by the way.
You're kidding.
And I woke up the next day, and everyone, you know, my phone was just nonstop, just notifications, you know, everyone telling me, you know, like,
you're the guy. I can't believe
it. All these things coming up, and I'm like, what the hell, you know?
So what's the next move? I mean, at a point, if you're getting all these offers, what do you want to do? I mean, you got all these options now. Do you have, like, an idea of where you want to take this now?
Man, I want to take this to the next level. I want to be acting as much as possible, you know. I want to be... Really, I'm not going to be picky about it. I just want to be able to entertain people and make people happy and do the best roles I can get my hands on, really.
So, Lino, here's an offer. I'm wondering if you've gotten an offer from this particular outlet. People who watch the show remember in season one, I described you as sort of the annoying little rich kid, but you were also the annoying little rich kid who was eight and roughly eight and breastfeeding still. So a lot of jokes online have been that, you know, that breast milk really did
that's hilarious.
Did a body good. Has the milk industry reached out yet to do an ad with you?
Well, no, I'm thinking of starting my own brand, really. I think it could really be quite successful.
Robin's breast milk.
Hey, where are you right now, by the way?
I'm in London. So this is where I've grown up, you know, this is my city.
So do you move to Hollywood now? I mean, that's leading man territory, country.
Who knows? I'd be up for it.
Huh. What are you doing right now? I mean, are you in school? Are you doing acting full time now?
Well, yeah, I've just finished a course in theatre design here in London. And I'm now just doing roles. I've got a few projects coming up, which I'm trying to keep low key, trying not to say too much about.
Well, Lino, one quick thing. Don't sign any contracts right now. Okay, I mean, you should get some advice because you could really score big now.
Well, yeah, I'll see. We'll see how it goes. I'm looking forward to it, really.
More, just as importantly as career options, just wondering, with all the attention, are there other options that are being presented to you? Sort of, as they say, people slide into the DMs who want to spend a little more time with you.
Right. It's there's some interesting stuff going on in the DMs, right?
It's very interesting in the DMs, yes. I would imagine. I would imagine it is. Well, good for you, Lino. Enjoy it, man.
Thank you, man.
I meant the career options. I mean, you know.
Oh, yeah, yeah. No,
and
no,
the
I
DMs,
know.
Too. Yeah.
Now, enjoy both of them.
Enjoy both, exactly, man.
Hey, listen, Lino, it's... hey, real quickly, what do you think of the criticism of the season and the finale of the series?
And people who want the whole season to be reshot.
What do you think of it?
I mean, I think the producers have had a tough job to do. You know, I mean, everyone, the writers, the producers, everyone making this, you know, they're having to live up to all the expectations of the series. And it's a tough job. I wouldn't like to have been in their shoes, you know, the level of pressure on this kind of thing. I think they've done the best. And I've enjoyed it so far, but I can understand why a lot of people are not so happy.
Hmm. Okay.
Well, if they do reshoot the season, I'm pretty sure they would definitely bring you back.
Sure.
No one wants to change what happened with your character.
I hope so.
Yeah.
Congratulations on all your success there, Lino. Really.
Thank you, guys.
All right, man.
Pleasure to
Good talking to you. Yeah.